On Guishui Street in Datong District, Taipei, it is hard to imagine this row of old houses with yellow-green tile wall used to be the hub of public brothels. This preserved building, Wenmenglou, will tell the story of Taipei from a different perspective. From the mid-19th century, after the opening of the Danshui Port, the center of Taipei's commercial port slowly shifted. Unlicensed brothels already existed at the time, while business opportunities also moved from Mengjia to Dadaocheng.
在大稻埕的地区呢，最主要就是本岛的娼妓跟义旦，那大部分就是聚集在江山楼啊，跟各种各样的酒楼。在日治时代就有公娼制度的存在，那这个也是国民政府来台之后，一个参照公娼制度很重要的一个来源。对，所以当时候在民国大概五十几年的时候就有娼妓管理办法，那在那个时候文蒙楼就已经是公娼馆了。
它是一个大概兴建于1930到1940年代的这个昭和式的一个建筑，整个这个建筑其实它是一个一砍一进的一个格局啊，那立面大概就是保有昭和时期的这个立面，四柱三窗，还有那个黄绿色的国黄砖，它的内部保持着民国41年吧以后的这个公娼馆的这个格局。
Measures for the administration of public prostitutes in Taipei classified public prostitution into three levels, A, B, and C, according to their facilities. Brothels could only charge the service according to its grade. Meanwhile, regulation on health and safety management were also established. On the wallpaper next to the phone at the counter, it still has the phone number of the Datong police station, which was written with a marker.However, as for the 100-year-old former homeowner who still lives in the residential commercial Wenmenglou, he is a walking encyclopedia of the evolution of this place.
那个时候，客人伺候小姐是有了，婚具就在这里啊。我们就打电话叫婚具的警察来啊，解决这个事情。
In 1997, the Taipei City government announced that the public prostitution system would be abolished. That triggered a public prostitution protest.
我觉得1997年的公娼抗争到后来，公娼自己成立了日春关怀互助协会。我觉得那个动作和那些年做的抗议活动，就是在对这件事情进行不断的诉求，不断的诉求，希望法令可以变化。
The protest movement aroused the attention and reflection of many people. Nevertheless, the buffer period for the prostitutes still ended on March 28, 2001. Although the land of Wenmenglou belongs to the Bank of Taiwan, the building is privately owned. By 2000, Wenmenglou entered another stage of discussion between urban renewal and preservation of cultural assets.After the collective of sex workers and supporters continued to propose to the Cultural Affairs Bureau, Wenmenglou was designated as a municipal monument in 2006.
Wenmenglou 的被指定为市定古迹啊，它基于三个理由。第一个理由，它是代表在当年代的一个建筑一个特色。其次呢，我们古迹不一定说是建筑物，而它的这个历史。或者他在这个整个社会的一个发展过程，这也是一个无形的文化资产。那第三个理由呢，主要是一个室内的格局。台北我们演一般的街屋，他一定是前面是做生意，那后面他自己住家或者二楼是住家。可这个地方不一样，你看他这个一楼，他本来这个一楼这个地方有六个小间，后来因为在缓冲了两年，他又增加了，也增加一些浴室，所以少掉了变成四间。所以这种格局我们认为是这个公娼的一个特色。
The collective of sex workers and supporters and the owner of Wenmenglou went through 6 years of back and forth bitter discussions. And in 2017, the collective of sex workers and supporters was evacuated from Wenmenglou. Then, the owner had to start taking care of the municipal monument as well as presenting a maintenance plan.
这是文化，文化先驱的后面有很大的教育使命，这个我们很深切的，所以我们用蛮谨慎的高标准在处理这件事。我相信很多人对我们这个古迹的期待性非常高，所以我想把它恢复到最繁荣的那时候的那个娼妓的真正空间。
The restoration plan for Wen Meng Lo finally managed to get the restoration and maintenance project subsidy from the Taipei City Department of Cultural Affairs and the Bureau of Cultural Heritage of the Ministry of Culture in 2019. This, plus the owner's own funds, was able to fully repair Wen Meng Lo and welcome new guests again. If Wen Meng Lo could speak, what story would it want to tell society?The preservation and opening of this monument could perhaps represent the acceptance and tolerance by the society.
社会进步，建筑会改变，社会形态也会改变，各种生活方式也会改变。那我们不希望任何一个时代的他的生活是一个空白的。让小孩子知道在过去有这个历史，也许在过我们现在或者在以后，他的性教育是另外一种事。
How many people have been lost in the nights of this red light district? Under the bright flashy lights, a precious historical story is preserved. Many years later, Wen Meng Lo still stands and gently reminisces its glorious past, while standing firmly in support of its mission.